It's mid-November and prime holiday decorating time is upon us. In today's video, I'll show you how to transform resin pine cones and balls into sparkly and glimmery home decor pieces you can display all season long. I saw this pine cone and the two sizes of balls and immediately knew that I wanted to glitter them for the holidays. You don't have to. This is how they come from the package. They have this kind of time-worn, whitewashed look. They're really pretty just the way they are, but for me and the holidays, it's going to be all about glitter. I'm not going to work with them this way. I'm choosing to add some color. I'm going to use Finnabair's new icing paste, and I'm going to bring in some of her art alchemy paint. So when we talk about these, there's one pine cone. It measures about 4 inches. About 4 inches this way, so from side to side, by about 6 inches long. When you look at the two balls, the small one is about 4 inches in diameter. It stands about 5 inches tall, and then the last ball is about 5 inches in diameter, and it stands about 5.5 inches tall. So, glitter. One of the things that I really like about Tim Holtz's Vintage Platinum Distress Glitter Dust is it's very chameleon-like, so it looks kind of white gold in the container, and when I put it on something, so this pine cone has had a wash of Finnabair's Art Alchemy paint named Steampunk Copper. I just washed the color on there. Now, it might not be as visible for you on the camera as it is to me here in person, but the glitter here actually looks a little different color than this one does. This one I used Finnabair's Frost Pearl icing paste on, and I actually applied a reasonably heavy coat. To my eye, when I look at this, this glitter looks a little bit whiter than what's on the pine cone. So again, I think of it, it's kind of like a chameleon. It takes on kind of the cast of whatever that it's attached to. So the cool thing about these resin pieces is that they're porous enough that paint will absorb onto the surface. You don't need to use a multi-surface paint. So for example, we're talking about icing paste, and then we'll be talking about the Art Alchemy paints, but super easy to do. I have one of the pine cones started here. Let me figure out where it is. Okay, so the first ball that I did, this, as I said, was with the Frosty Pearl. This has been, I've started this, and it's the white gold, which is that what this is called? Yep, white gold, which is what's going on here. And I've just brushed on a light coat, lighter here than I did here. It's just a matter of how much you pick up with the brush. So let's quickly look at how that works. It's really simple to do. So I have a section here where I have not done anything. When you say icing paste, I generally think of something that I would pick up with a palette knife, but this stuff is actually pretty thick, but you can work with it with a brush. You don't need a palette knife. You could use your fingers with this, but if you do, use a palette knife or a brush to scoop it out. You don't want to take anything that might be on your fingers. Sometimes mold will bloom in the containers if you stick your fingers in there. So I don't want too much. If I'm going to kind of dry brush this, I don't want to overload the brush. And it's just a matter of coming in. Now, if I push and I really want to get, because you have these little, the thingies on the pine cone that are all layered on this, like this, if I push underneath, I could certainly get a ton of color on there. And if I brush sideways like this, I'm liable to get more color on. It's preference. It's just a matter of whatever it is that you want to do. But you can see how easy this is. And it will dry. It just takes, you know, it's like anything else. It depends on ambient temperature. It's November. Is the heat running? Are you in some place where it's warmer and maybe the air conditioner is running? Or maybe you're in Australia or New Zealand and it's hot and the air conditioning is running. So all of those things are going to affect how long it takes to dry. But you can see that I have not glopped the paint on or the icing paste on, and it's not going to take long to dry at all. So I'm going to let that happen, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you. So this was done an entirely different way. And again, I think that the lights are washing it out a little bit. This was done with one of Finnabair's Opal Magic paints. Art Alchemy paint is divided into three options. You have Metallique, Opal Magic, and Sparks. So this small ball was coated with this one is named Aqua Rose, with the Aqua Rose Opal Magic paint, which is technically an interference paint, but I like the way that it looks on here. Now this one, you'll notice, if I bring in one of the ones that's got more glitter on it, you'll notice that this particular ball has much less glitter than this pine cone does. What I did was when I washed the color on here, I knew that the whole ball was still wet, so all I did was pick up little fingerfuls of the glitter, and I just kind of sprinkled it on there, and there was enough wet left in the paint so that it just adheres. So if you want a little bit less blingy look with your glitter, you can apply it this way. I am going to show you the gel medium version after we get through playing around here and everything is dry. So for this pine cone, let me bring in the steampunk copper. For this pine cone, I put a light wash, so I thinned the paint out quite a bit, and I washed the whole piece with the steampunk copper. And then I came back and I dry brushed more of the color, undiluted, just on the tips of these, and I don't know what those are called on a pine cone, I'm having a moment here. So when you talk about dry brushing, you don't need a ton of paint, or if you take out too much paint, what you want to do is kind of brush a lot of it off so what's in the brush is pretty dry. And that way I can just hit the tips here and it will darken them without necessarily getting color up inside the underneath of the existing layers that are on top. And it's just a matter of, you know, you do this slowly and carefully, you add layers and you let first ones dry and you come back and do more. And really that's all there is to it. I haven't decided if I'm going to go ahead and glitter that one. I'm probably going to play around and after the fact and see how that goes. So let me just clean this up. I'm going to just spritz some water on here to get rid of that. And you can see what happens. This paint thins out and there's still plenty of color in it. So when you want to wash color on, that's an easy way to do it. Okay, so let's come back to this small ball, and what I'm going to do is bring in the sparks, because I haven't tried this yet and I want to see how this works. And I'm going to wash the color on initially, because I think I'm going to glitter this one, and I'll probably just do the sprinkle thing. So I'm going to put some water out here, and I'm going to grab a brush and scoop a little bit of paint out. I don't need a ton of paint for this, because I want a really thin wash. And if I wanted to dry brush in the way that I did a moment ago, I could come back and do that. But I'm probably not going to. I'm just going to put a really thin wash of the Sparks paint on. So you can see it's very water-like, and I think that this might be too much pink for what I had in mind for this. So all I need to do is, let's get the paint out of the way, is add some more water and thin that color down. Now if I want to thin down what's already on there, I'm going to have to come in with some water to do that. And obviously when you put this much liquid on, it's going to take a little bit longer to dry than dry brushing like I showed you a moment ago with the steampunk copper. But you know, you can always take a heat tool to it if you want to speed that process up. But this is it. This is pretty darn simple. So it's just a question of me finishing this, and then I'll let everything dry, and then I'll come back and I will show you how I go ahead and I add gel medium, which just plain old Dina Wakely's gel medium. I'm going to use it on a brush, and then I'll come in and I'll put the glitter on top. So here is my small ball with that coat of Butterfly Spells Sparks paint completely dry. You can see, or at least I hope you can see, that it's very light, and with the sparks what you get is a much more glittery effect. So this is what happens with the metallic. You get this more solid coverage. With the sparks, it's sparklier. That's literally what the paint is more sparkly. And then when we look at, this is the Opal Magic, when we look at the Opal Magic, it's a completely different look. So three different types of paint are going to give you three different looks, and then when you bring in the icing paste, it's its own entity and is going to produce yet a fourth look. So with those four options, you can create all kinds of interesting effects. So gel medium, it really is, it's an all-purpose thing. It's something that I find very useful all of the time. It has its gel medium applications when you're working with paint, but as an adhesive, it's really good because it's multi-surface. So it's going to stick to just about anything that you apply it to. Now the deal, the way that this is going to work is however much gel medium you apply is how much glitter you're going to see. So for example, if I come in and I kind of mimic that dry brush thing that I did when I was showing you how to dry brush on the steampunk copper, if I just lightly brush, and I'm going to go kind of vertically right here, if I just lightly brush that color on, or excuse me, brush that gel medium on, and I come in and I'm just going to catch the glitter excess with that, and I put some glitter on, you can see that it's a reasonably light coat. It's, in fact, there's nothing right here. If I had only stroked over this once, so for example, if again I mimic this dry brush thing and I come down here and I put one quick stroke on, I'm going to see less coverage than I did over here. You can see how much lighter this is. There's far less glitter. So you can do this, Or you can do this, or if you want to amp up the bling a little bit, what you can do is put on a heavier layer. Now, if I hold the brush kind of at an angle like this, the gel medium is going to accumulate kind of on the tips of these little layers here, and that's the look I'm aiming for. Now, I'm being super careful. I don't normally do it this way, but I'm trying to make a point. All right, so let's just, now I'm putting on a little bit thicker layer. If I come back and I put some glitter on here now and I knock off the excess, you can see this now is a completely different look. It's much more solid, but it really is confined just to the tips of all these little layers that make up that, well, this is kind of like a pine cone ball, that make up all these little layers. Here really light, and here more coverage. Even though I was dry brushing, I stroked over this several times. So your options are pretty much wide open. Now obviously I'm gonna come back and clean this up so the whole thing eventually looks the same rather than having three different looks the way that I do now. But it's so simple to do. You can do this with kids. It's a fun holiday project for them. It doesn't take a lot of time and it's easy to get really nice results.